Good morning to all of you. On 17/5/2021, the Honorable High Court of Kolkata, Acting Chief Justice Rajesh Bandal and another judge Abhijit Banerjee, while disposing the writ petition number 10504 by 2021, clearly held that mobocracy should not be allowed and rule of law should prevail in the state. This is the direction they have given while staying the orders of bail granted by the lower court in the Narada sting operation case or Narada scam case. So you can refer this as the case of CBI ACB Kolkata versus Shri Farhid Hakim alias Bobby Hakim, he is the transport minister, Bobby Hakim and others, right, 2021. You may be knowing, this sting operation has become a sensation. It should have toppled the government, but luckily the government of TMC once again came to power in the elections held recently, and the announcement of the results were on 2nd May 2021. So, the people who were caught in the sting operation, after all, for a paltry sum of 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs, as per the directions of the Honorable Supreme Court and High Court of Kolkata, the case was registered by CID in the year 2017. On 26th April 2017 or so, they registered a case in crime number 10/2017 under section 120B IPC and also section 7, 13, 13A, B, C, D of the so-called Prevention of Corruption Act. Of course, on May 7th, the Honorable Governor of Kolkata, he has given permission to sanction to arrest and proceed against the accused persons also. So in persons of the same, on 17/5/2021 in the morning, the CBI arrested 4 people who are almost ministers and other dignitaries. 4 people. Number 1, Farhid Akram Hakim alias Bobby Hakim, he is the transport minister. Subrata Mukherjee, he is the Panchayat Raj minister. Madan Millai, he is an MLA. And also Sovan Chatterjee, ex-mayor of this so-called Kolkata corporation. Both of them were arrested. All the 4 were arrested and they were brought to CBI office. Up to this, it's okay. But learning about the arrest of their people, the CM, it is Mrs. Madam Mamata Banerjee, she along with 300 supporters, she stormed the office of the CBI at 10:50 a.m. and she staged a dharna in the CBI office up to 5 p.m. raising slogans, and she dared the CBI to arrest her also, because she is also, let her be an accused in the CBI, the so-called Narada sting operation. So she came to Nizam Palace, where the CBI office is located, and started dharna. At the same time, the law minister of Kolkata, he went to the court and along with so many people, and he sat at the court up to 5 p.m. So actually, their intention is different. The intention may be anything, but they wanted to create the so-called mob psychology or mobocracy, right? So immediately, an urgent petition was moved, house motion was moved before the Honorable High Court of Kolkata by the CBI, and it was taken for hearing on the same day, right? Actually, on behalf of the so-called CBI, the Standing Council asked for the transfer of the case under section 407 CRPC, because High Court is competent to transfer cases wherever expedient or necessary. But the court said there is some time and the rules may not permit, even though, because CBI people can hold the fair and impartial inquiry. So, but the CBI said it is not being allowed to function properly from the Nizam Palace due to the so-called obstructions by the Chief Minister, none other than the Chief Minister, as well as the Law Minister in the court. Right. Now, the court did not agree for the same. The court has sent or he has actually given caustic remarks against the so-called mobocracy. Why? Because The rule of law should prevail. When would the people come to the court? Normally, they think it as the last resort. In the initial stage, they do not approach the court. Normally, they will come. They will settle the issue with the elders. They want to mediate. They want to take the advice of some others. And out of all these methods fail as a last resort only, they come to the court. So confidence is the number one. Confidence should be the number one in the judicial system, because if the confidence is eroded, if it is taken away, then if mobocracy is allowed, then the public trust will go away. Therefore, the public trust and confidence in the judicial system, it is definitely most important. So public trust and confidence in the judicial system is most important, because it being the last resort. Normally, by seeing the so many people, the public may have a feeling that it is not the rule of law which prevails, but it is a mob which will have an upper hand, and especially in a case where the chief minister and the law minister personally take part, right, which should not be allowed. If the parties believe in the rule of law, they should get away from this place. If they want mobocracy, we are not going to tolerate them. In the meanwhile, it came to know light that the lower court has granted bail to the so-called four persons. But the Honorable High Court has stayed the proceedings, stating that normally it will send a feeler that due to the mobocracy, the court has given bail. So immediately, the High Court has stayed the order of the lower court and asked them to stay in the CBI office itself. Of course, you may be knowing, later they were allowed to be in the house arrest. So, as stated very recently, I told you the case of Rupesh Kumar or something, where house arrest is suggested by the Supreme Court itself. Installing habeas corpus. I think this is Rupesh Lal versus State of UP case. I am not able to recollect the case from anywhere. Right. So this is the discussion. So please remember, the High Court clearly stated that the rule of law should prevail, but not the mobocracy. That means people should not think by gathering so much mob, they can get the law in their favor. This is what the High Court wanted to say. It is a very important judgment. Please read it and enrich your legal knowledge. Thank you.